Hello everyone, my name is John Melisondra, and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today I'm going to paint something like an ocean. Everyone, I'm going to put a galleon, a boat there, or a ship on the ocean, okay? And I think it will be a little bit of sunset scene, okay? And please don't forget to subscribe, you have been subscribed it, and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there are 5 limited colors, the brushes that we need, and all the things that we need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and I'm going to put under painting first. I'm going to use this 1.5 inch flat brush, or you can say it's number 30 flat brush. Okay, so let's start. I'm gonna paint the sky first. A little bit of purple, blue, and white, a little bit of red. Can use some blue and white only. I just want to create a bit of brighter skies, everyone. I can put more blue there on the top. To make the color darker. There. I have to put some blue around here, on the top. I have here the red and then the white, so the horizon will be here, a little bit bottom. Then I'm gonna put the purple here. There, I'm gonna spread the little bit purple color. Okay, so here I'm gonna try to make it darker. Blue and the red. There. A little bit of white. So this will be the darker clouds, everyone. I have to spray the colors here, like that, using this brush. Actually, this brush is good for doing that. Spreading the colors. There you go. So I have to put some white here, the bottom part. Okay. Then I have to put some colors on the sea, everyone, or the ocean, something like that. So I like to put some blue green there, blue and the yellow and then white. There, I like this color. Like a turquoise, okay? Blue and the yellow, so it's a bit green. Okay. So it should be straight, everyone. I'm gonna use this brush. It's a number 8 nylon flat brush. It's a medium size flat brush. So blue under umber. So I know not blue on room, but it's a purple color, red and blue and blue one. Red and blue and the white. Okay, that's good. I think I need to make it that straight, but Yeah, I have to make it that straight, everyone. It's important to make the horizon straight. And put the horizon below the center of the canvas. There you go. I think that's fine. I have to put some orange line here, because this is an afternoon, so we expect that the sun is coming down, something like that, and my light is coming from the left side. Okay, so clean your brush. Good. I have here the yellow and then red. You can put more red and then white. I think I have to put more white. I have to spread a little bit here, but make sure, everyone, that this color is lighter. Okay, as you can see now. There you go. Yeah, so you can see a little bit of orange, and here, everyone, I'm gonna try to have a bit of orange clouds here that hit by the sunlight. Okay, so I can use this purple, reddish purple, so red and blue, but more red than white. There you go. That's too much bright, everyone. That's too much dark. Just add white there. Then I'm gonna put a little bit of white. Okay, it's now morning here, and I'm gonna put some a little bit of white here. And then now I'll try to mix some a little bit of orange, everyone. Yellow and the red and then white. There, I like this orange. lights coming from the left side, everyone. Just blend it here. Okay, that looks good. Okay, so I can see now, everyone, the clouds there. It's really good. I think I'm gonna change a bit my, but I want to put more here. Some lights also, even here. And then I'm gonna try to use a smaller brush now, the number 2 nylon flat brush. So let's add some white and then yellow and a little bit of red. So we have now this beautiful part of the clouds, everyone. It's purple, this orange clouds there, and it looks good. Even it looks great, simple and great. Okay, yeah. And then I'm gonna put some clouds, also dark clouds, on the bottom part. Okay. Yeah. So here I'll try to use a bigger brush. This brush, everyone. So I'm gonna use this blue and the red. I'm gonna put a little bit of white because that's too dark. So you can see now the darker side of the clouds. We're gonna try to put some white also. Not white, but a little bit of gray, yes. There you go. I'm gonna try a little bit of white. Gotta put it there, everyone. So we have now this beautiful dark clouds, everyone, and other parts there you can still see some lights also. So yeah, I like it. It looks good. It's just so simple and it looks good. Okay, so I'll try to sketch now the galleon ship. Okay, so I'm gonna try to paint the big ship there in the center, a little bit of our right side of the painting. So yeah, I'm gonna make it as realistic as possible, okay? Okay, there you go. So I'll be using a smaller brush, this one, a 09er brush, and again I'm gonna use this umber. So the shape will be here. Yeah, from here, I think. And then here, it will be huge shape. So maybe here also. To be huge. Yeah. I think I'm gonna touch it like that, make it smaller here. There. Okay. So here one is to have a bit of perspective. I think it should be here. Yeah. It should be a try and error method, everyone. Okay. So I think I need to adjust again. Okay, everyone, I need to adjust something there. I think that's enough. So it's a trial and error. We need to have a lot more patience on this one. Okay. I think I need to retouch something, but I think that's enough for me. I will just my drawing is a bit off, but I have to continue on this one. I think it will just come to one place later on. Okay, I'm not sure, but I think it's fine. Okay, everyone, so I have to add some darks now. So I have here the blue and the red to make some purple, dark purple. Actually, I'm not using any black, everyone. I'm using just dark purple. So if you're painting, remember just follow what I'm doing. And always have fun. So I'll just try to add more darks. So I have here the blue and the red. One more red. There. So I'm gonna have some amber, red, and then yellow. More yellow and the red. Okay, so on the bottom part, I'm gonna make it more like brownish. And romper. So here one, I'm gonna make it dark. I mean on the top, I'm gonna make it much more romber. With a red color. Cause this is made of wood, everyone. So usually the color is something like brownish. There you go. And I'm gonna try to put some poles there or something for the sail or something. I don't know what to call that. I'll just try to use this blue and the red, but I'm gonna put more red. It will look more reddish purple, something like that. It should be straight. Okay, I think it's not perfectly straight, I'm not sure. Yeah, I think it will be until there. So I'm gonna make it thicker. So the other one will be here. Yeah, so I will not make it on the same level. So I'm gonna make it thicker, everyone. Okay, here you go. Yeah, so a lot of details there. I'm gonna try to put more. I mean, here, everyone, there's one also here. Yeah, later I'm gonna put. I'll do this one first. The first cross and the second cross. So it should be here. So I should be a bit careful of that. There. Okay. And the other one here. And the other one on the top here, everyone. Go. There. It's okay, everyone, if it's a little bit bigger. Okay, and then I'm gonna put also one here. And then there's another pole, but this one is not so tall. Okay. There you go. So I've been there, but I'm gonna put a lot of details also. Okay, so I think I'm gonna put what do you call this? A sail here or something, like a white cloth. As well in the this galleon thread or something like that. Okay. So I'm gonna use this brush. And then I have here the raw umber and then white. Okay, so wait a bit, everyone. Okay. there, okay? So it will not be hard. So I'll put a little bit white. Okay, so I don't know if it's on the front or, yeah, I think it will be on the front, everyone. So the other one also we'll put. Let's change this one. I would try to change. Even on the top, everyone, we can put also there. We'll put more white. Then also this one. Okay. There. This one also here. Okay, so you have now like that, everyone. We have now like that, and then I will try to put more details using the smaller brush before I'm gonna put those lights there. So again, this one more. This should be here. Okay. I can put something on the top, on the tip of the. So I'll put now some rods, everyone. So careful with the stroke, everyone. It should be very, very small. And put a lot so that it will look more realistic, everyone. Yeah, I'll try to add details also this this cloth, something like that. I'm gonna put lights first. Well, maybe I'm gonna put the highlights. Because later I'm gonna cover it with the rod, with the everything there. So I have here the white and the yellow. And then I'll try to put some light inside. Yellow and the red with a little bit of raw amber. And then more yellow. There. And then white. So the light is coming from the left side. There, okay. It should be much more lighter. But I'll try to also to put some purple. Yeah, this is a bit bluish purple. Go. Okay, I think that will be fine. I'm gonna try to add a bit darker on the corners. There. Okay, everyone, so I think I like that. Yeah, it looks fine. Okay, so I'm gonna continue. I'm gonna put more ropes now. So I'm gonna mix again for blue and the red. There. So I have to put a lot of details, like the ropes there. Sorry. I think I'm hungry. Okay. So even though it's not so perfectly copied everyone like in the photo, but it's okay. Okay. There you go. Yes, we have now this beautiful details, everyone. So I will try to put now also details here. I'm gonna make it darker also here. Blue on the red. More red. So we have a line here. One is a detail of the sheep. Okay. Also, hey everyone, I'm gonna try to put some darks. Another detail here, I will do also here first. There, so we have now a bit of the details, and it looks good. Okay, so I can see now a little bit the details on the ship, everyone. It looks good. I know that everyone can also do this. It doesn't look hard. Yeah, I'll try to put a bit of lights, even there's this one here. Then I will try this orange. I'm gonna make the body brilliant even with the highlights. I can try a lighter orange. So I have to put details everyone. Some lights, anything there that would look more realistic. It will add realistic effect on the painting. There. And I have also raw umber and the red with yellow. I think more red. So I can see much more reddish tone on the bottom part. And there are also some dark parts here. Okay. Yeah. So we have to add more details, everyone. Realistic details. I have the raw umber and the white. I'll try this one. There you go. And so I have to put some light here. Some light strings or some light ropes. can't even hear everyone. You can see now plenty of details. As you can see, you know, our boat is it's glowing with the lights coming from the sun. Try to lighten this white here. This, I think it's a window, small windows. There you go. Okay, so for now I'll stop on this details. I'm gonna try to put now the details on the bottom part. So it's been 1 hour 30 minutes, everyone, and I think we're almost done. I think I'm gonna proceed now on the bottom part. I'm going now to add out details in the in the water, everyone. So here I'll try to add a little bit of orange details. So yellow and the red. And the blue, and then white, little bit of reflection. And then I'll try to put some white, also some white foams. So I'll be using this one. So just a white here, everyone, on the side. that I have here, the white and the blue color. So I'm gonna put the reflection of the sky. In the far part, everyone, I'm gonna use this a little bit of a reddish purple and white. It can be bluish. A little bit more bluish. Okay, I like the, it's very very clean, everyone, and it's quite. So I'm gonna add more reddish purple. So here I'll try to add a little bit of water disturbance. Okay, it looks good. It's just so simple and it looks effective for me, everyone. I like it. And we should not forget also the reflection here, but I'm gonna do it later on. I'll try first to add some blue green. I'll put some white there. or the little bit of shades on the waves, everyone. That you can blend a little bit. There you go. And then I will try to add more blue green and then white there. So I'm going to put a little bit of there. Okay, so yeah, it becomes a bit of realistic. You can see the waves on this beautiful seawater or turquoise color. I'm gonna put also some water reflection. I'll just use a light amber, everyone, a little bit of orange maybe. So here. So you can see now a bit of reflection coming from the boat, from the ship. Wait a little bit, everyone, and make sure the colors are light brown. See. It's not so much obvious, but I can see here. Yeah, I need also to put more light blue on the top of the this color. Slowly, everyone, the thing become bright. Yeah, so it's now coming a realistic. Okay, so I think I'm gonna need to lighten a bit more on the light brown, everyone, for the reflections. Okay, yeah, at least you can see now the reflection of the boat. So yeah, I think I will be finish on this one, everyone, because I'm trying, I want to put some island there, but I think this is enough. I don't want to put any island there. Maybe I'll just put some whites on the white foams on the boat, and then I will be finished. There you go. So I think I am done, and I'm very, very happy with the entire result. And I hope you are also learning. So even though we are doing it just very, very simple, especially in the water, everything, it looks realistic for me. I like the color there. It looks brilliant.
Okay, everyone. So I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.